If you have a health insurance policy, when you make a claim on the health insurance policy, it's perfectly possible that the claim may be rejected by the health insurance company. And it happens for many. What should you do in case if you are at that point of time where your health insurance claim is rejected? In this episode, we are going to discuss what are the options in front of you, what you can do, and see that this claim is passed. This is NRI Money Clinic, and I am Dr. Chandra Kanbat, investment consultant and a financial planner.
NRI Money Clinic, no hype, just the right advice.
Dear viewers, if you are in the unpleasant situation wherein which a claim on a health insurance policy is rejected by the health insurance company, what can you do? To answer these queries, I have brought to the studios my eminent faculty on health insurance, Mr. Harish Prabhu. Mr. Harish Prabhu has a very rich experience of working in the health insurance segment for close to a decade now. He works as an associate business manager at Manipal Cigna Health Insurance Company. Welcome to this show, Mr. Harish Prabhu.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Prabhu, many people complain that when they make a claim on a health insurance policy, often the claim gets rejected.
Yes.
And they do not know what to do with it.
Okay.
They have bought a health insurance policy with an intention that it will come out handy when they really need it the most.
Correct.
But how can a health insurance company reject this claim? What happens in that case? What is that they can do as a policy holder if their claim is rejected?
See, mainly what will happen is when a claim comes, the company and the hospital are mainly involved. The hospital, whatever writes in the case sheet, is the decision making for our claim department. This is the first point everybody has to. Means your whatever the doctor writes on the case sheet is very, very important.
Okay.
Point number one. Okay, when it has been cancelled or denied, it's mainly because of the write-ups given or the details given by that doctor. Or it may be on the present claim or it may be on the past history.
Okay.
The moment it has been rejected, we have to see two points.
Okay.
The claim is rejected upfront or only cashless is denied?
Oh, which means to say that the company may say that I will not do a cashless claim.
Absolutely.
But you still have a right to make a claim on the plan.
Yes, because cashless has to be done with certain TAT, turnaround time. And company has to maintain that TAT. Company may not get that much of time to investigate that issue and say, I will agree this cashless.
Okay.
So most of the time, cashless is rejected and it has been requested for the reimbursement. Most of the clients think that cashless rejected means claim rejected. No. Sorry.
This is exactly what happens. They go to the hospital, they are not prepared with the required amount of cash. They think that their policy has a cashless benefit which is packed into it. And because of the short duration of time, the claim estimation department, whether it's a third party or in-house claims department, cannot make a decision on it.
No.
And it informs the billing desk that no, I cannot give you the cashless claim. And people think that my claim is rejected.
No, most of the things customers think that whatever health card they are having, it's like an ATM card. At the last moment, I show it and take the cashless. No. See, there are certain steps for the claim. The moment you enter into a hospital, you need to inform that hospital insurance department with all the your case history. At that moment, insurance department will get the case sheets and send it to the insurance company for cashless. The moment we get the cashless request, we look into the case sheet and whether the pre-auth will be approved or not.
See, the policy holders also have to be careful in this issue.
Yes, absolutely.
When they go and present their case to a hospital, they have to be very, very specific while giving answers to doctor's queries.
Absolutely.
See, for example, I'll tell you an example. If a person has purchased a health insurance policy 15 years before.
Correct.
And he is diagnosed with diabetes in last 5 years.
Correct. Right? Exactly.
The doctors have to do their duty. They have to take the case history. They'll ask how many years you have been suffering from diabetes. And if these people simply say diabetic for many years, it can give room to interpretations.
Absolutely.
If you say, I am diabetic for last 5 years.
Yes.
And the policy was purchased 15 years before.
Back.
You are well within these things.
Absolutely.
But if you use the word, I have been diabetic for many years, many years, it can give an interpretation that you have purchased a policy without declaring this particular thing at the beginning itself. So this is perfectly
very
possible.
Very, very true.
You have to be very, very careful in what you tell to the doctor, and it's a good idea that you ask the doctor what he is going to write in this particular thing.
Good.
It's always better that whenever you have purchased a health insurance policy, maintain a copy of the application form itself, and it's definitely not a bad idea to show it to the doctor when you make a claim on that, so that the doctor will know this is what has been written in the application. See, I don't mean to say that you misrepresent the fact here. All that I mean to say is being careful can avoid a lot of unpleasant situations.
Absolutely perfect. Absolutely. Okay. Now, when the claim cashless is rejected, the client has got all the rights to come for the reimbursement.
Okay.
And reimbursement will be done as per the company norms. Few companies will give 15 days time, few companies will take 30 days maximum. Okay. In 15 to 30 days, the claim will be most of the time settled. In case if they reject the claim, that time the customer can ask the company to reopen the case with the relevant proofs telling that the claim is genuine.
My question is, if a company rejects a claim, is it not duty bound to give the reasons in writing why they have declined the claim?
Absolutely. They will give the exact reason why they have not, why they have rejecting the claim. They will give with all the clause, points, everything.
Okay.
But still the customer may feel whatever the reason they have given is not genuine, which is in fact wrong.
Okay.
In fact, it is wrong.
So, either the insurance company is right here or the customer is right
here. Right here.
Now, what is the view of insurance company? Customer will not agree. Or what customer has said, the insurance company will not agree.
Yeah.
Now, there should be a mechanism wherein which either of them have to convince the other.
Yes.
And arrive at a conclusion on this particular
thing. What will happen if the request for the reopening? This time, the case will go to the grievance department.
Okay.
The grievance, there is a grievance cell in every company. They will involve along with the legal people and with the claim people. There will, in the committee, there will be all the three departments: legal, grievance, and the claim. So they will discuss this case, and there is a big chance of giving this case to the third party, outside resource.
Neutral person. Okay.
Now that neutral person will take some turnaround time, and he will investigate that case. It may require his physical meeting with the client, physical meeting with the hospital, physical requesting for documentation from that particular hospital, and he will prepare a project on this, and he will submit to the insurance department.
So there is a time within which they have to act.
Yes.
On it. It is not open-ended.
So in everything has got a turnaround time. So he will submit that report to the claims. Most of the times claim will get settled after this investigation.
Okay.
Most of the times. Still claim is not settled and rejected still. Because when a company rejects a claim, there is a strong reason behind it. Number one, it has been clearly proved that it has been fraudulent claim, or non-disclosure of the claim, or further non-disclosure but negotiable. Still, company may feel in further course of the time they have to keep continuing this claim, which is a big cost to the company as well as the other customers' interest.
Okay.
Because their premium may vary.
Yeah.
Because of this.
Okay. By favoring one person, it will go against the benefit of others.
Yeah, absolutely. So they may reject it. After rejection, the client has got all the rights to go appoint a advocate and go to the consumer court.
Okay.
Now, consumer court also, when it goes here, the compliance department enters into the case and see whether it is from our side, company side, or whether it is from the customer side. If it is from the company side, many have to give their head.
Okay. If they are found faulty. Okay.
Many has to give their head. Otherwise, if it is customer side, company will appoint the legal advocate to fight the case in the court.
Okay.
The result will again depends on the judge and the court. After results, again the customer has got all the rights to go to the ombudsman, where our company, whoever, the insurance company and the client has to put forth their views,
arguments
and views. Finally, decision will make. So here what I suggest is, all the customers are kings. They have many options to work on their case. Don't think that a claim has been rejected and it has been gone, my money is gone, I lost everything. No, never.
When you make this particular point, one thing that comes to my mind is, there is a major role for the intermediary to play here.
Absolutely, sir.
The person who, see, these are the days where you buy things online. These are also the days where you are approached by some agent of some company and who sells this policy.
Correct.
If you are a person who is buying it online, it's fine if you are comfortable with it, but it makes sense for you to have a proper intermediary who can be a liaising person between you and the company to understand the different interpretations and how you can sort out this particular issue.
Correct.
So use the intermediary in between. If you have bought this policy with the help of an agent, or you can walk into the branch office and ask them to explain these things to you. Okay. See, it could be a simple involvement of waiting period.
Absolutely.
See, in a normal course of time, let's say it's a cataract or something has to do with the prostate, which has a normal waiting period of 2 years, and unfortunately it came up during this particular waiting period. It's not your fault, it's not the fault of the company. It's because of the clause which is there in the policy. It could be sorted out. It's easy to complain that the insurance company has declined your case, but it makes a great effort, it makes a good sense for you to understand why things have happened. So it is very essential, even from an insurance company's point of view, if a person has purchased this policy with the help of a mediator, the mediator should be informed, asked to mediate between the company and the person, because when a claim is disallowed, obviously the customer is agitated.
Absolutely.
He has purchased policy for his help, and when he needs it, it is not there. Now, if you are on the right side, your intermediary, your agent or a branch or whoever should take that extra steps to convince the customer what he needs to do.
Yes.
Either he is right or wrong, or what is the redressal mechanism that has to be taken.
Correct.
See, most of the people, see, when they are in a hospital, they are in pain.
Absolutely.
They are in pain. And when the rejection happens, they are heartbroken. And they do not know what they have to really do at that point of time.
Correct.
This is where the role of the intermediary really comes into help there.
Correct.
And it's the duty of the insurance companies and the intermediaries, if they are involved in that, to help the customer and sort out their problem and make sure that the claims are paid to the policyholder if they are due for it.
And also I request the clients always, see, you when you buy the policy, you keep probing the person and see that he is a knowledgeable person. Simply because of the I just want to give to this person, then better to give a charity rather than to take the health insurance.
Absolutely, absolutely. See, it is rather unfortunate that there is no professionalism which is really building in the intermediaries.
Exactly.
It's time people get into this as a career, not as a part-time workers, with a full seriousness. Put your mind and soul into it. Take time to understand the policies, how you can help the customer, and that can go a long way and creating happy experiences.
Correct. Most of the times, customers give on obligation and they don't have words to ask for the service. Obligation. See, I request everybody, please don't go for obligationally sales.
Yes.
Knowledgeable person with a lot of probing, whatever in your mind, any doubt, please feel free to ask while taking the contract.
Yes, absolutely.
Before signing the contract, ask each clear all your doubts. Then only you go for the things. Just don't go because someone has taken and I have an obligation, I want to give it to this person. If you have obligation, go with the charity, not with the health insurance.
Brilliant words, Mr. Prabhu. And intermediaries are duty bound in this.
Correct.
Well, dear viewers, if you at any point of time that the health insurance claim has been rejected in your case, please make sure you follow a step-by-step process. First, find out whether it is rejection of cashless claim or an outright rejection of your claim. If it is just a cashless rejection claim, you still have a claim on your policy. You just have to apply for a reimbursement of costs. If it is an outright rejection of your policy, the company is duty bound to give you in writing under what conditions they have rejected this claim. If you are not happy with the decision of the company and you feel that you are on the right side and company is in an arbitrary manner is declining your case, you can reopen this case by writing to the grievance department.
Yes, correct.
Even after the reports from the grievance department, if it is not in your favor and you feel that you are cheated or you are unduly rejected with this particular claim, you have recourse in the form of consumer courts, you have a recourse in the form of regular courts, you can also approach to the ombudsman.
Yes.
It is fair to say here, if you are on the right track, I can tell for sure with my experience of over 2 decades in this line, the companies will rule in your favor. No company would like to reject a claim because it will work like a negative publicity for the companies. So it's in your best interest that you buy these policies. After reading through the conditions, make sure you make proper declarations. However trivial it may look like, it makes sense for you to write down in the application. At the same time, keep a copy of this application, and whenever a claim is made, it is better you take this application copy to the doctor and tell him, this is what you have declared in this thing. What doctor writes and what is actually factual, let it tally with each other, and that can save you a lot of embarrassment at the time of making a claim. So, Mr. Harish Prabhu, thank you very much for bringing all these answers to the benefit of our viewers. Nobody would like to get a rejection of a health insurance claim. But if you are at the receiving end, hope the episode that we have done today helped you to understand how you can maneuver through this and make sure you properly represent to the insurance company. If it helped you to understand this particular subject, please like this video. If you are a person who is watching this episode for the first time, or if you are yet to subscribe for this channel, please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon. Don't forget to share this video with your friends and relatives. Thank you very much for watching this episode on NRI Money Clinic. I shall be back with you with yet another topic in yet another video very, very soon.
Press the bell icon for more details and subscribe our channel.